Two Town.
We live in a big, beautiful world. I'm Leo.
I'm Andy.
And I'm Carmen. Our parents work in a circus that travels all around the world, and we travel with them.
So we never know where in the world we will end up next.
But wherever we go, we know that Luna the Moon will be there with us.
Traveling the world as a trio. Andy and Carmen and Leo.
With Luna the Moon and some new friends too. Everyone's different and really they're just like you. All around the world. Let's go, Luna, let's go. All around the world. Let's go, Luna, let's go.
Way down in London town.
Whoa! This hole is so deep.
Here comes another hall. Thank you, Mr. Angry Digging Bug.
What you doing, Andy?
Oh, hey! There's this cool bug digging down in this hole, and he keeps bringing up amazing rocks. It's the deepest hole ever. Here comes something else. Ow!
What is it?
It looks like an old coin.
Old coin?
It says something about Victoria on it. Who's Victoria?
Victoria was Queen of Great Britain and the entire United Kingdom in the 1800s.
Luna!
Luna, come and play.
Luna's here, what do you say?
Luna, bright as day.
Show us the world, lead the way.
Hey, Andy, what you got there?
A coin, Luna, and it looks super old.
Yep, it's old, all right. Where did you get it?
Just over there. A bug brought it up from a really deep hole.
Well, that's no surprise. There's over 2,000 years of history buried right under where we're standing.
Whoa! 2,000 years? But this looks like a modern city. What kind of city has that much history?
You want to tell them where we are, Magic Globe?
I would love to. Hi, everyone. Today we are in the city of London, the capital of Great Britain. And yes, there is that much history here and more. London was founded by the Romans about 2,000 years ago, but back then it was called Londinium. Eventually the Romans left, but London thrived throughout British history. From Vikings in the 8th century, to William the Conqueror, to Shakespeare in the Elizabethan age, to Queen Victoria, to swinging 60s London, to the modern city of London we know today. There's so much history buried beneath our feet, the farther down you dig, the farther back in time you go. Back even to the time of the Romans.
Wow, it's like an underground time machine, Magic Globe.
Right you are, Andy. Have fun in historical London, kids.
Thanks, Magic Globe.
Wow, that means there's got to be so much more cool stuff to find underground. Hey, Bug, anything else down there? We're looking for more historical stuff. Huh? Whoa, what is this? Hey, everybody, look at this. Another treasure.
That's cool, Andy.
Yeah, what is it?
Well, you know, it's one of those, that you... It's,
You have no idea what it is, do you, Andy?
Sure I do. It's a baseball from the time of medieval knights.
A baseball?
It doesn't look like a baseball, Andy.
That's because it's the special kind that knights in armor used. Just imagine.
I'm okay.
But what I do know is that it's mine, and I'll never let go of it.
Oh, there it is.
I'll be taking that.
What?
Cheerio.
Hey, come back. That's mine.
Don't.
Okay, anything is possible.
Where are we?
In Reggie's groovy pad, baby. Hello, Luna.
Hi, Reggie.
What brings you to the most far-out layer in the London Underground?
Luna, you know this thief?
If you're talking about this, mate, I spied it first. Then Charles snatched it and rolled it up to the surface.
Charles?
The angry digging bug. So technically, it's mine. A groovy addition to my collection.
What exactly do you collect, Mr. Reggie?
History, my far-out butterfly. London Underground is the hippest place to collect the coolest. There's all kinds of groovy stuff buried down here. With stuff like this.
What is it?
Why, it's obviously a dialer vibe. Popular in the swinging 60s, baby. You simply put the vibe flow like so, insert your money thusly, dial the vibe you want. Super far out was 9. And, cool vibes for 6p.
Are you sure that's what it was used for?
I think it's a telephone, Reggie.
Trust me, I'm an expert at these things.
Well, if you're such an expert, what is this?
This? That's easy, mate. Everyone knows this is a... It's a biscuit maker. That's right. Hundreds of years ago, you would roll it in the dough and make biscuits, yeah.
Wrong! It's a medieval baseball, and it's mine! You took it from me!
No, I saw it first. It's a biscuit maker, and it's mine!
The bug gave it to me, so it's mine!
No, mine!
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 Let's go! Give me that! I'll get it!
Baby!
No way, baby!
Come on, guys! We gotta help Andy!
Here we go again.
Almost got it!
Get out of my way! It's mine!
It's mine! Great! Now where'd it go?
You know, guys, I believe your cool round thing is way older than you think.
Yeah, we don't even know what layer it came from.
That's right. Magic Globe talked about layers. The farther down you dig, the farther back in history you go. And since we don't know how deep Charles the Angry Bug was digging, the round thing could be from any time.
Righto, mate.
So that means it could actually be a Viking snake catcher.
Or a Queen Victoria cheese grater. Yeah.
Hey, I know. The one who comes closest to what it is and the time it's from gets to keep it, and that would be me. Because I have the best imagination.
Ah, but I know the most about the London Underground. I know every nook and cranny, every layer, every happening in the past. And this city is so very happening, baby, yeah.
In good old London town, as we go down under the ground and take a look around, with every layer, the things you see are from further back in history.
I dig digging in the dirt, so I'm already feeling fine. And I know exactly what it is, and that means that it's mine. Back in groovy hippie days, I think this shiny ball swung from the swingingest necklace of them all.
No, 400 years before, a rider one windy day, afraid what he was working on would all get blown away. To be or not to be, there's really no debate. It became William Shakespeare's favorite paperweight.
A golf ball from the time of knights.
The end of a wand of a jester wearing tights.
Wizards casting spells have probably happened all the time. Come on, it's mine.
No, it's mine.
No, the thing is mine.
So desperately we tunnel, seeking answers to it all.
It's a special kind of fancy sort of British bowling ball that makes it mine.
No, it's mine.
For the last time, I'm telling you it's mine.
Mine, baby.
No! What a wonderful relic.
Hey, you! Where are you going with that?
Hey, come back here!
Stop!
Now where are we?
Well, you're in my study. Why were you chasing me?
Because you stole my property.
Hey, you mean my property.
No, it belongs to you. Well, okay, well, here you go.
You guys, this is Nigel. He is the top expert of London Underground.
Ooh, Mr. Nigel, I know you're an expert and all, but I bet you've never seen one of these before.
No, I've seen a few.
Then you must know what it is. Is it a medieval baseball?
Or Queen Victoria's cheese grater?
It's a Roman dodecahedron.
Oh, sure, of course. Oh, yeah. I knew that.
Nigel, what exactly was a dodecahedron used for by the Romans?
Well, that's the mystery, isn't it? We've been trying to figure that out for years. Some say it was used as a toy, or a knitting tool, or to measure sunlight. But the truth is, the only thing we know for sure is that it was Roman. However, there's much more history to see down below London. Come, let me show you something. Welcome to my own underground glass elevator.
Wow!
I built this so I could observe all the layers of history. From the Romans to the time of the knights to the swinging 60s, all creating the foundation of progress upon which today's London was built. Despite all that wonderful history in the underground layers, my favorite part is up here, the vibrant modern city of London. Well, I must be heading back.
Reggie, Nigel knows way more about Roman dodecahedrons than we do. He won the contest, so he should keep it.
Yeah, baby.
Nigel, Reggie and I think you should have this.
Really? Well, thank you. I shall study it with great vigor. Farewell, everyone.
Bye, Nigel.
Well, you guys have all been super groovy, but that's my ride. See ya!
Bye, Reggie!
What a great day underground.
I know, right?
Luna, I'll never look at digging a hole the same way again. Learning about how the city grew makes me want to explore even more of London.
There are always new things to explore wherever we go, Andy. But remember, there's always tomorrow.